Hi guys, welcome to the Media Ruda show on A1R Psychic Radio. Last show I talked about to keep faith in yourself. This time I would like to move on this subject for a little bit more. Your life path is to travel to an unknown destination. Well, unknown, not exactly, but you need to travel some distance to get a possible clear view of your personal goals. From being yourself to your destination is the most difficult piece of your life path. Generally, in the beginning of your life, you will be attracted to do as everyone. Not that what everyone does is wrong, but you will need to be yourself. From your childhood up to the moment you make a turn in your life is a path which travels quite easy. It can be a long distance. That means it could take you 40, 50, or even 60 years to get to your turning point. Being yourself and make choices which fit your personal life is the hardest. You will feel selfish and rude to follow your goals, but in the end, you will create happiness in your personal environment. It's not something that always will happen, of course. Many people grow old in a situation where they have started their life with. One choice is not better or worse than the other. It depends on the character and personality of specific persons who will make certain choices or not. Compare your life path with a physical road. You start in a protected area. Then it will be a city zone. After that, you will hit the highway where you will make choices or not. It also depends on what you do with resistance and obstacles. I could talk for hours through this because there are so many exits on a highway to avoid resistance and obstacles, and there are also so many unexpected obstacles. Then you will need to improvise a solution on that specific point. People who did not have a protected area in their past immediately start in a city environment. Many influences from outside and no protection in the past. That is a real difficult start of your life for sure. But everybody will travel to a certain destination. You are in charge and you decide what to do in specific situations. So if you feel too much resistance in your current situation, generally there will be some roadblocks coming up that will force you to yourself or to stay in your current situation. Changes do not directly mean that you will need to end your current relationship or move to another living environment or change your career, for example. It actually means you will compare your personal life path together with your situation. Many things generally can be integrated, but some adjustments can be needed. And yes, there are situations where you will have to face some changes. Keep in mind that changes always hurt directly and immediately. Proceeding your life path and ignoring the signals seems the right decision to make because it doesn't generate immediate pain and resistance. But in the end, it is a path of long pain instead of short pain, if you understand what I mean. Motivate yourself first by realizing you are worth to fight for. Also know you are capable to achieve your goals. Unless past situations, try to stay positive. Otherwise, you can't motivate yourself. Know that following your heart is not difficult, but every decision you make, you feel instead of you know. Knowing something doesn't hurt, but feeling something, that may hurt. That is the main reason to avoid following your heart. The first few miles are the toughest, but when you are rolling and get used to this path, you will enjoy every second of it. Don't look around to see if you can do it. Look at yourself, and you know and feel you can do it. But this show isn't about me talking all the way. I need to tune in on some energies. Let's see if we have a caller right now. Well, I see a caller. It is Lori from Aiken. Good evening, Lori.
Good evening.
How are you this evening?
I'm doing great.
Great. How can I help you, Lori?
I was trying to find out as far as the relationship that I'm in right now.
So your current life situation, and you need to know where you want to go in the future. That's what you mean?
Yes.
Yes. Let's see. I feel at your side at the moment some resistance. I see some vague overview of your future. I definitely feel a huge spirituality at your side. So you are very sensitive, highly sensitive. You have very strong capacities in your spirituality. Are you working with your spirituality, or do you use your spirituality in your daily life?
I couldn't hear you.
Do you use your spirituality in your daily life? Because I feel so strong spirituality that it is like you are working with your spiritual gifts.
Yes. I'm just trying to figure out. I'm with an older gentleman right now in a relationship, and I was just trying to see if that's where I need to be.
Yes. What I feel about that situation is I feel some resistance between the both of you. There is the man and yourself. So if I look to the both of you, I see some kind of a distance between the both of you. It feels to me like you're not really talking to each other from your heart. So there is some discussion between the both of you, but the discussions is more generally about general aspects instead of some feelings you have, how you feel about some situations. I feel really a lot of difficulties from your side in this subject. If I look at his side, I feel he's a little bit in his mind, in his head at the moment. You are really in your heart, so that means you're facing some miscommunication, because there your heart is at another frequency of the head. So that means, because you are talking something, you are discussing something, and he doesn't understand you correctly. That's what I mean, because he can't feel what you mean because he's in his head. But I really feel a lot of unspoken words from both sides. So to me, that means if you talk together, if you connect back together, I can't feel you need to break up.
We get along really good together, and we have a lot of things in common. Sometimes the age is the issue.
Well, the strangest thing is, maybe the number he's carrying with himself and you, it might be a big difference. But what I feel about you is that you are older in your energy than the man is. This man is... he has a quite adult age, so that means he has a lot of life experience. I also feel some difficulties in his life path, so it wasn't all that easy for him. So he has some luggage in his trunk, but that doesn't block him for moving on with you. There is a good connection between the both of you, but I feel that it seems you also have some sadness. I feel some grief at both sides. Like, you love each other, but yeah, I can feel it in my eyes already, the signals of my guides. They really give me all the signals that there is some sadness between the both of you, like you are afraid to lose each other out of sight. You really should connect back together from your heart. So you are doing right, because you are already in your heart. So you are also talking from out of your sensitivity, your spirituality, trying to find out how to come closer together. But he needs to calm down a little bit. He needs to be more self-confident on himself. I feel also on his side, he is a strong energy. He's a very positive energy. He's very, very sensitive. It's a very sweet man. He would never break your heart to punish you, but by protecting himself from certain influences to his heart, he can hurt you, of course. He's not doing anything wrong. I only feel that he needs to be more in his emotion. He needs to accept his emotional part of his life more for himself. That can connect himself more with you.
Yes. Another quick question, and I won't hold you up any longer. My son, I lost my son 5 years ago. Do you do anything with past life?
Yeah, past life. You have a specific person for me, or do I need to check?
It was my son that passed away 5 years ago. He was 18. And I just didn't know if you feel anything, him coming in.
Yeah, I feel a lot of struggles with your son. I also feel a lot of grief with your son. I don't really get a very strong connection with your son, because I see your son is with you. Your son is also in your house. So that means your son is not only in your personal environment or with your partner, but he's also in... It is his house, or also where he grew up, I suppose, because he feels so at home at your place. That means to me also he feels guilty, because he's looking to the ground, so he feels guilty. He's a little bit ashamed. He feels really at home, like he wanted to be more at home. So did he had a life where he was often outside?
Yes, he lived with me when he died. He was with me when he passed away, as far as living with me. In my home, I've experienced some things that I couldn't sort of explain, and I feel that it was him.
Yeah, because the energy is quite moving around, so it's a very restless energy. It's not because he's not doing well, it's only because he is traveling, he is snooping around, he is very curious, he likes to learn a lot. So I also feel this energy would like to talk with you. I am definitely sure, because your spirituality and your sensitivity, you feel his. You feel he's with you. You feel when he's there, and when he's connecting with you, and you feel when he's taking some distance, when he needs to calm down or to, he needs to rest. He gives me a lot of stress. I also have a strange sound in my voice because of your son. So that means when he passed away, there was something. Did he scream a lot, or did, because my voice is like it's damaged?
I couldn't hear what you just said. I'm sorry.
Yeah, no problem. It is my voice is really getting a hard time on me. So that means to me. Did he scream when he passed away? Because I feel a lot of stress at his situation.
Yes, a lot of stress. I'm trying. He left behind a daughter, and I'm trying to be able to see my grandbaby.
Yeah, it's he. Let's say he is, that sounds maybe strange, but he is happy where he is right now, because now he has a kind of control on his life. I get a confirmation from my guides. So that means in his physical life, he didn't have the control on his life. He was also extremely sensitive, also very highly spiritual. It's an incredible energy. It's a new age child, I am for sure. He feels like very strong, but also very weak. So that means the sensitivity took the overhand, like to say. Now he is at a place where he has the kind of control. He can control you. He can control his situation, which he left on Earth. I also feel some irritation. So he was also kind of irritated, frustrated when he was on Earth. Also when he passed away, it wasn't really a choice of him to go to the other side. But now he is there, he realizes it's okay. So he accepted the situation. I also feel that for you it's a huge loss. It's incredible, because normally your child should bury you instead of the other way around. But somehow I feel from your spirituality that you understand that he is there.
Yes, I do.
Yeah, but it is.
I'm a very strong-willed person, and I've sort of surprised myself how well I have dealt and coped with it. Like I can't understand where all my strength has come from.
Yes, your strength is coming from the other side, because you have double energy, because you have your own energy and you have the spiritual energy. And the spiritual energy is your connection with the other side and the earth. So from the earth you get the clean energy. When you think about somebody, when you feel on an energy, you get some energy to you and you give back some clean energy. So that means the information you get spiritually, that comes from the other side. So that's from, your son is definitely a new age child. So your son, I think it is possible that your son makes you stronger since he passed away.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you so much.
Yes. Thank you also so much for calling, Lori. And I wish you all the luck and strength.
Thank you. You have a good night.
Thank you. Bye-bye. So we have Marlene from Los Angeles, California. Good evening, Marlene. Marlene, are you there? I think we lost Marlene. Maybe we had some technical issue. Maybe the spirits were that strong that they messed up our connection with Marlene. Well, that's no problem at all. Then I will give you some little bit more insights on choices on your life path until we have back a caller, so I can tune in on the energy of our next caller. So the travel, Marlene is back. Good evening, Marlene.
Hi, how are you?
I'm
Thanks
very fine.
My
Thank
call.
You. No problem. I didn't want to waste a second, so I immediately checked in with you.
Wonderful. This is great. So I'm so glad for the opportunity.
How can I help you, Marlene?
Okay, so I'm wondering if you can tap into my love life, future. What do you see, if anything? Any potential?
Yes, let's see what I feel with you. I feel some kind of loneliness at your side. I also feel some unspoken words in yourself that need to come out for some reason. So, do you have a relationship in your current past?
Currently, no. I recently broke up with someone about a week ago. And that's like, for me, it's coming to an end.
So, you have a relationship right now? Or
someone else. Oh, go ahead.
You have a relationship in your past, so you have an ex-relationship.
Yeah, about 5 days ago.
Yeah. Yes, so I feel there are some unspoken words, because it is an ex-relationship. So what I feel about that relationship is that this relationship, yes, it is an end. So I don't see that relationship coming back in your current life. I definitely feel some unspoken words, I feel some difficulties, and I feel the sadness. So that means you really have a break. So I can see you are coming back together, but there you need to discuss some things. It feels to me like it's not completely over or something about it. There need to be discussed about some issues. So if that has been done, for me it looks that you can look forward to your future. emotionally, it feels to me you are already disconnected from your past relationship. So you are already accessible for new love on your path. It doesn't surprise me when you connect with somebody in a relationship. I think, let's see, one, two. To me, it feels like you will have two new relationships in the near future. That means that will be temporary relationships. So you will have a friendship, you will roll into a relationship and you will end it. The second time you will do that again, but it will be a shorter period of time. The first one will stay a friendship. The second one will disappear out of your life because there is no connection. It was just a misconnection. Then I can see some parts of your life a little bit alone, so no partner. And then after a few months, so let's say in the next year, maybe summer or autumn next year, I see a permanent relationship for you with a man. It is a very career type man, strong energy, positive energy, kind of dominant, but positive dominant. He likes to go for the positive things in life, to get everything out of it, to enjoy life together with a person he really loves. Yes, to me it feels like he will have two temporary relationships and the third one will be a permanent relationship. So I switch to the permanent person because that's the most important for you, because you are looking to the permanent relationship. But you are open, you are accessible to social life, so to say. The permanent relationship, that would be a man. It is a white male. It's just American man. I see some black hair, dark colored hair, a normal skin, a little bit square face, normal nose and ears, a little bit small mouth with lips, the good nose. He has character and he also has some charisma. So he doesn't have to speak to express himself. Has a strong energy, he's also spiritual, but he is very practical. So that means he knows how to deal with the issues here on Earth. But he lives on his intuition. So he doesn't use his mind to live the practical way, but he uses his intuition and then he follows his heart to do all the practical decisions in his life. So to you, that would be perfect because at the moment you are a little bit in your head. That is because of your past relationship, because I feel some discussion. I also feel you're not really yourself at the moment. You need to calm down. There's a lot of stress in yourself. You already hear me talking very rapidly. There is also a lot of communication stuck inside of you, which needs to come out. So normally you are a very social type, but I get the feeling in your past relationship and in your past, the people has blocked you being yourself. And now it feels to me like you're not enjoying your alone, but you're enjoying you can be yourself right now and you can make the choices which are important for you. The man, I definitely feel like the permanent relationship, you will meet him in your career. So it can be some, because you are employed at the moment, because I see some routine at your site. You are working for a boss?
Well, I'm my own boss. I'm a contracted to work. So, yeah, I'm my own boss.
You're almost.
Well, I'm not like a business owner or anything. So, yeah, I guess technically, yeah, I do have to answer to someone.
Yeah. Because that's what I wanted to say. It's not a colleague of yours, but the man you will meet, he feels to me like a person who can, let's say, give you some financial information, or who can do your finances, something with your, he will be on your path. It will be a connection with your career, but not like a colleague or a relation of your job, so to say. So to me, it will be a person who guides you with your finances. this guy, because he's also wearing a suit, so he has an official job. I also see he is working for some kind of huge building, so it could mean that you will need to deal with your finances, or you will need to deal with some kind of sort of company. It feels to me like some company which is from the department you live. So that man will help you. There will be a connection. It is a connection you can't ignore, because it's not a person you really love with your eyes. So it's not a person you say from, wow, it's a Don Juan. But it is a very beautiful man, but it is not completely your type. But the connection is so strong, you feel that this is the genuine love you are really searching for your entire life. And that man gives you the connection you need, and that man gives you the power back in your life. You get the energy back, you get your social life back.
Oh, wow, okay. And does he, like, I mean, I've been told this, that the guy that I'm supposed to be with is, like, very athletic or likes to go to the gym? Yes. I don't know, is he like that? Not that I care, but yes. I just wanted to know.
It's a big person. He's tall. Yeah, he's tall. I think he will be almost 2 meters tall. It's a very big man. Not fat, but long. Very muscled body, indeed.
Oh,
I see.
Okay.
It's like about 6 foot. So, but I see we have some 30 seconds left, and before Dave, the producer, will cut us off rapidly, I will have to finish. Our show.
Wow. Okay. Well, thank you. I mean, unless there's anything else, but I really appreciate this reading. It's very insightful.
Thank you very much, Marlene, for calling in. And I would like to thank all our listeners for listening to the Medium Garuda Show on A1R Psychic Radio. And I hope to hear and see you back next week. Bye bye.